Hey guys, K171 here again, and this is my response to this week's Top 3 Tuesday. I said it right this time. And this week's one is by PsimanUK. I think that's how you say it. When I first saw and heard that in the video, for some reason, I was thinking Cybermen from Dragon Ball Z. Which is very weird, and I don't know why I told you that, but I haven't thought about or even seen Dragon Ball Z in about 13 years. So, whatever. Anyway. This is... Actually, by the way, I've been doing Top 3 Tuesday ever since the very first one, and this is the closest I've come to not being able to do it. So, we all know it's going to happen eventually. But it'd be cool if I never missed a single one. Like I said, I've been doing every single one since the first. So, and I enjoy it. And I know it's responsible for getting me a lot of the people who watch me, so I owe it. Anyway, Altered Beast. I have to explain a little bit. In Altered Beast, you start as a human, you get these power orbs, and you can turn into... Altered Beast, as the title says, or Beast, singular, in this case. No, 16-bit cartridge is not the subtitle, although it would be a cool subtitle. The back of the box actually tells you what all the monsters you could become into, just like the manual does, although the box actually, the back of it, tells you every damn level in the game, because there's so few of them. The one for me I chose is the Were-Dragon. You have two moves. One is just like a normal wavy energy beam, but it's the second one I chose. If not just for its sheer annoyance and its OP status, overpowered. It's basically the shotgun of this, like in Doom. You ride the shotgun in Doom. It's really weird, so I gotta read to you exactly what it says. B button, that's what it's assigned to. Laser barrier, not what it looks like. I'll show you what it looks like. With an electrified thermoray, again, that's wrong too, anything that touches you will be instantly fried. Or so much as pop fade away, or if there's enough shit going on the screen, it'll just glitch out and fade away. Altered Beast is an okay game. It's not a perfect. It's not a great game. Let's be honest. There it is, right there. You're that blotchy dark thing you can't see. I did this before, and there it goes. That electric looking crap around you. That's that move. So, yeah. This manual blows. Anyway, moving on from there. We have TMNT, or Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, Hyperstone Heist, brought to our crazy friends at Konami. The same ones that think change the color of an enemy makes them different. You're very imaginative. I wonder if we could have got a multiplayer Metal Gear Solid that way and had like a pink snake, a green snake, orange snake, and maybe a polka dot solid snake running around. You never know. Although Metal Gear Solid 4 and all the crazy ass camo colors you can have, maybe. Anyway. Don't have the manual for this one, by the way. Which is a shame. Anyway, it's a very good game. It's another brawler. The move I chose in this is actually one you can't perform yourself, like with a button combination. It's actually a pickup, but it still counts. Like the pizza pickup, which gives you health, it's a square too. It's orange or red. But this one has like a picture of a cartoonized bomb. You know, black with the wick. And it's lighting up and has yellow thing around it. It shows exploding. You pick this up for about 7 seconds, no matter which turtle you're playing as. You'll spin around, and if your enemy comes in contact with your weapons, they'll instantly explode. Because this game apparently also runs on the GoldenEye engine, just like GoldenEye. Only this game is better than GoldenEye. Anyway, it's also on a better console. So, yeah. It's good. Like I said, it works for any enemy, regardless of their color. Although the different colors, actually, they do certain different things, but whatever, it's still stupid. Anyway, number one. You knew Mortal Kombat was going to be here. Where, as I should have said in the beginning, I actually imposed some rules on myself because I keep breaking rules of Top 3 Tuesday. Call for my box. Anyway, I only chose the first one because, yeah, looks nice with the dragon logo. Well, actually, I did choose it specifically. Whatever. No fatalities, obviously. Mortal Kombat is my favorite fighting series, as many of you should know, even if you only saw a couple of my videos. It's pretty much impossible for you not to name drop Mortal Kombat. Or frickin' Ghostbusters. There you go, it's been a while since I've done that. I gotta have fun putting all these back in alphabetical order again. Yeah. So the move I chose in this is Kano's Cannonball move. I don't know exactly what it's called. So, yes, I realize I'm wasting time. I apologize for this, but I can't remember. Kano. It's on the next page. Special move, cannonball, towards, down, away, up, towards, block, spin, in place. Yes. He jumps up in the air, levitates for a very split second, puts himself to a cannonball, launches himself at the enemy, and pounds him in the face with his full body force. That is brutal. That looks very painful, you know. I don't know. It's something about that just is absolutely brutalizing. It was either that or in Mortal Kombat 2, Kitana's fan sword throw, which, you know, that could be deemed as pretty painful too. But something to me just screams, damn, that's gotta hurt, having someone's entire full weight. And you also gotta think of how Kano does this. Imagine if you're fighting him. He's all of a sudden standing there, then he jumps up, rolls himself into a cannonball, somehow magically, knows the force, I guess, launches himself at you, and boom, in your face, his full body weight. Don't tell me you ain't gonna have your skull turn into powder. Kano's a dirty son of a bitch when it comes to fighting, so, yeah. My number one is from Mortal Kombat is Kano's cannonball move. So that's mine. I know it went a little longer than I wanted to, but whatever. That's what happens. So check out EDT1138. And I'll be honest, I never heard of him until now, but that's okay. There's tons of people on this site. PsimanUK. I'm going to check him out after this time. I'm not going to make any more videos today. So thanks for watching. I will see you next time. Sorry it's longer than what my usual response is. Whatever. I'll see you.